Vaibhav Srivastav from Vaibhav E-Learning Academy. Today we are going to continue our topic squares and square root. This is our part number 3. In the previous video, we have learned about the Pythagorean triplets. I hope you have enjoyed that video. In today's video, we are going to learn about finding square roots. Now first, what is square roots? Today what will we learn? We'll be learning about what is square roots. Then we will learn how to find the square roots by three different methods. First method is factorization method. Second method is subtraction method. And third method is the main division method. So now let us start with the first thing. What is square root? Now for example, if you take any number like 5. And now if you multiply it by itself, you get a number. So now here 5 is a number. So this thing can be said as 5 square is equal to 25. Now here 5 square is 25. So now this is called the perfect square. This is a perfect square. Now for example, you have this 25. You are set to find the square root. Finding square root means finding the number 5 like this. So, you will be given the answer here. Like your 5 square equal to 25. You will be given the answer, that is this number. You will be given a perfect square. You have to find out which number square is it. Now, let me take another example. 36. Find the square root of 36. So, 36. Now, what is the symbol for square root? So, this is the symbol for square root. So, this is square root of 36. The square root of 36 is equal to 6. How is it 6? Because 6 into 6 is equal to 36. So, square root of 36 is equal to 6. Now, let us take one more example. If you take square root of 49 is equal to 7. Why? 7 into 7 is equal to 49. So, this is what is square root? So now you know the basics about the square root. Now how to find them? Now how finding square roots? There are mostly three methods of finding square root. First is the factorization method. Second is factorization. Second is subtraction. And the third one is division. Now, how can you find any square root by factorization, subtraction and division method? We are going to check them right now. So first, factorization method. Let me write this factorization over here. Factorization. Now, let me take an example of any number like, let me take 81. 81. We know that 9 square is 81. Okay. So now, first of all, we take the number 81. Then, we make like this. So now, 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. So, 9 divided by 3. Here, factorization. So, what is factorization? Means using prime numbers. You know what is prime numbers? The numbers which have only 1 and the number itself are known as prime numbers. So here, first prime number will be here 3. Now, 3 ones are 3, 3 twos are 6. Then we'll get 81, then twos are. Now 6, 2 is remaining. 21 is 7. Let me explain you this. First you take the number 81. Now, you know, do you know how to find out whether any number is divided by any number or not? If you see 81, so you can see 8 plus 1 is equal to 9. And 9 is divided by 3 and 9. So now, it means that the digit 81 is also divided by 3. Now, you have to divide this 81 by 3. So 81 divided by 3. 3 2s are 6, 7, 8, balance 2. And then 1, 21 will be your remainder. So this is what 21. I mean, it will be coming as 21. Yeah, 27. So 81 we'll get by 3 is equal to 27. Then again we can divide it by 3, we get 9. Again by 3 we divide it, we get 3. Again by 3, we have to do it until we come till 1. So now, 81, root of 81 is equal to 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. 3 into 3 into 3 into 3. Now, how can you find out the square? Now see, as you know the word square. Square means to the power of 2. So now you will be taking 2 values from the left. Now this will become one simple value, single value. Because let me again explain you. 3 into 3, 3 into 3. Now we have to make in pairs. Why? Because it is square. When you go to cube, you have to make pairs in 3. Now it is in square, you have to make pairs of 2. If there is 2 into 2, you have to make a single pair and make them 1. I mean, not 1, 2. You have to make them all into a single number. So like that, we have 3 and 3. Then multiply 3 with 3, which is equal to 9. So root of 81 is equal to 9. It is so simple to find out, by the way. Now, let me give you another simple example for understanding. So now, I have the number 36. First, we will try to solve this by 2-digit number, then we will solve it by 3-digit numbers. So now 36. First of all, see, can it be divided by 2? The 1's place is even, so it can be divided by 2. 2 1's are 2, balance 1 and 6 is equal to 8. Again 2, we get here 9, because 2 into 9 equals 18. Then 9 cannot be divided by 2, so 3. We get here 3, again 3, until we get 1. So now, square root of 36 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. Now as I said, you have to make pairs of 2, 2. So first we'll make a pair of 3 and 3, now 2 and 2. So these two will make it into one number, that is 2. Into these 2 threes will make it into one number 3. So square root of 36 is equal to 2 into 3. Thus square root of 36 is equal to 6. Now do you understand? It is actually very simple if you try to understand. Let us take one more 3-digit number. Let us take a 3-digit number now. Let us take a number 200 actually. Let us take a number 144. So first, see by which number is it divisible. So you can see here by 2 it is divisible. So it comes 7, then 2. So 2 7s are 14, 2 2s are 4. Then again it can be divided by 2. So 2 3s are 6, balance 1 and 2 is 6. Again 2. So we'll get 18. 2. We get 9. 3. We get 3. 3. We get 1. These are the factors. So these are called the factors of 144. So now the square root of 144 is equal to 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into 3 into 3. 2 into 2 into 2 into 2 into, 2 into 3. 3. First, see, we have to make a pair. One pair, two pairs, three pairs. So much into one. 2. 2 and 2 again 2. Here we get 3. So 2 into 2 into 3. Root of 144 is equal to 2 into 2 into 3. Thus, root of 144 is equal to 2 2's are 4, 4 3's are 12. Root of 144 is 12. Let us check it. 12 into 12. 2 2's are 4, 2 1's are 2, 1 2's are 2, 1 1's are 1, 4, 2 plus 2, 4, 1. So here we get the number 144. Thus we can say that the square root of 144 is 12. So this was our first method, finding square roots by factorization method. Our second method is by subtraction or repeated subtraction method. Let us see. Bye. So now we are going to continue our topic from finding square roots. The second one over here is repeated subtraction. Now, what is repeated subtraction? As the name suggests, it is subtracting repeatedly. Let me give you an example. Now, first of all, before going for an example, we had learned in a property video that there is one property that all the square numbers can be subtracted by odd numbers. Let me explain you how that comes here. So, for example, we have to find the root of 49 by repeated subtraction method. So, first, what we do is take 49, subtract 1 from it. You get 48. Now, take 48, then subtract 3 from it. You get 45. Take 45, then subtract 5 from it. You get 40. Take 40, subtract 7 from it. You get 33. Take 33, subtract 9 from it. You get 22. Alright, you get 23 actually. Yeah, 24. So 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33. Now, take 24 and then subtract 11 from it. You get 13. Then finally, take 13 and subtract 13 from it. You get 0. So, what we did here? We took 49, first we subtracted 1. Then you got 48. Took 48, subtracted 3, you got 45. We repeated this until we came to the answer 0. Now, if you notice the numbers, you see that we first went 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13. These are odd numbers. And let us take one more thing. This was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So we had subtracted 7 times. Thus, the root of 49 is equal to 7. Like, let me explain you again. Take 49, subtract 1. From then with answer you get subtract 3, then subtract 5, then 7, 9, 11, 13. You have to keep on going until you come to an answer zero. So that's what we now here after subtracting I came to the answer 0. So I subtracted 7 times. So the root square root of 49 is equal to 7. Let us take one more small example. Now, like for these, for repeated subtraction, you can use only small numbers. You can't use big numbers. For example, if you go 144, you have to keep on subtracting 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11, 13, 15. So it will be a very long list. So better than that, you can use the prime factorization method. Now let me take another example. Find the square root of 36. So what? What will we do? First, 36 minus 1 is equal to 35. 35 minus 3 is equal to 32. 32 minus 5 is equal to 27. 27 minus 7 is equal to 20. 20 minus 9 is equal to 11. 11 minus 11 is equal to 0. So now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. We did subtraction 6 times. Thus, the root of 36 is 6. So, like, this is very simple actually. You can do by subtracting this until you come to the answer 0. So, then after coming to answer 0, calculate how much time did you do the subtraction. That is your answer. This was very easy. This is the second method, repeated subtraction. So now, the root of 36 is 6. Now, let me again clarify you once again. So, like we have the numbers over here, like 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So, these numbers are the odd numbers. So, what are the odd numbers? So, these are odd numbers. So, we had learned in the property that the square roots are in the sequences of odd number. Like square of 1 is 1. 1 plus 3 is equal to 3. Then 3 plus 5 is equal to 8. So like that we kept on going. So these all are the properties of square root. So from this property, we can say that the odd numbers are actually helpful for finding out the square roots. Now let us move on to the third one and most important and little bit difficult one. That is the division method. Let us see. So now guys, it is the third method. It is time for the third method and the most important method. This is the main method of finding the square roots. Division method. Now this is the division method. Now what is division method? As you can see, the name suggests it is by doing divisions. Now if I explain you, you won't understand until I give an example. So first our example, let me write it over here because we have to write here. Find the square root of 225. Find the square root of 225. So first, take the number 225. Then you have to divide it into two pairs starting from the right. So first make these and then this. Now making them in pair is known as, like the making them in pair is called periods. So now these are known as periods. So these things are known as periods. So we can say that this is a period, this is a period. There are two periods in this sum. So now let me add up this 225. I have to write down 225. Then make it like this. Now make them in their periods. Now first, what you have to do is, first you have to divide from the left. Now if you take 2, what is the square of 2? Square of 2 is 4. But here, that is, if you take the square of 1, you get 1. And if you take the square of 2, you get 4. But we need the perfect square as 2. It means that we have to take 1. And let me explain you once again. Now if you have here 2, like in normal divisions, what you do is you find a number which is less than or equal to the number to subtract. Here, what you need to do is the same thing. Find a number which should be less than or equal to the number. So let me take here 1 and multiply 1 by 1. You have to write the 1 two places. Minus 1. 2 minus 1 is equal to 1 and then 1 plus 1. Is equal to 2. Now what you have to do is take this second period down. Now we have here 125. Now we have to find a number after 2. Like you have this 2, right? But now you have to put a number which will come in the ones place. So if you have the ends, like if you have the unit digit as 5, then what number can have unit digit 5? 5 square is equal to 25. Only 5 can have its perfect square as 25. So now we will take 2. Then we will take 5. And multiply by 5. 5 5s are 25, balance 2. 5 2s are 10. 125. So we will take 1 5 over here and put the same 5 over here also. So 25 times 5 is equal to 125. Then you have to subtract them. 125 minus 125 is equal to 0. Then your answer is 15. Thus, the square root of 225 is equal to 15. I know this is a little bit difficult. Now, if you want to check that whether it is correct, so 15 into 15. 5 5s are 25, balance 2. 5s are 5, 6, 7. 1 5s are 5, 1 1s are 1. 5, 7 plus 5 is equal to 12 plus 1 is equal to 225. So now we can say that the square root of 225 is equal to 15. So it is actually a little bit hard to understand, but once if you understand, each and every problem will be easy. Now let us take a slightly difficult problem to understand this problem. So now guys, we have our second example over here, that is find the square root of 274576. So we have to find the square root of 274576. So this will be actually a little bit difficult and it can be a little bit complicated to understand, but still let us see. So now here, first step is take the number and divide them into periods. So we have 2, 7, 4, 5, 7, 6. Start from the right. Take two numbers, make them into a period. Then take the next two numbers, make them into a period. Next, take two numbers and make them into period. So now why are we doing only two numbers? It is because it is square. Square means power of 2. So everything here will be only with 2. And if you take in cube, you have to take with 3 numbers. So now we have this thing. And now let us just rub this and get over here. 2, 7, 4, 5, 7, 6. Make them into periods inside this also. First, 27. Which number, like you have to find out which number square will be equal to 27. Not equal to 27 means which should be like near to 27. Now if you take 4 square, if you take 5 square, it is 25. If you take 6 square, it is 36. And 27 comes between 25 and 36. So we have to take the least one. So we will take over here 5. Then multiply by 5. Minus 25. 27 minus 25. 7 minus 5 is equal to 2. Now what you have to do? Now take the number, like you have a number over here, 5. Multiply it by 2. You get a number 10. Put the same number 10 over here. So you get it. Now what is this number 10? This number 10 is half of the divisor of the next number. You will understand all the terms one by one. So now here we have 2. Now we will bring down the 45. Now we have to find out any number whose, like you directly cannot find out which number has its square root as, which number has its square as 245. So now first you have to find out which number can have its units place as 5. So again, 5 square is equal to 25. Only 5 has its square place as 25. Then what will we do? We will take 105 and multiply by 5. Why I should multiply by 5? It is because the number which you are putting in the units place, you have to multiply it by that number only. 5 5s are 25, balance 4. 5 zeros are 0 plus 4 is equal to 4. 5 ones are 5. Now if you take, there is 545 and here we have 245. Now 545 is much than 245. So we will, now we can't take 5 because 5 cannot be exact. Now we will take 4 or 3. Now let me take here 3. 5 into 5 will be 525. So we will take some less number. So let us take 102. What if we take 102? 2 2s are 4. 2 zeros are 0. 2 ones are 2. Here we have 204. And then if we take 103 into 3. 3 3s are 9. 3 0 0. 3 ones are 3. 309, 204. Which one can we use over here? Obviously we should use the least one. So 204. So the answer will be 102 and then here 2. So we have 245 and here we have 204 minus 204. 5 minus 4 is equal to 1. 4 minus 0 is 4. And 2 minus 2 is 0. Now bring down the next. Now we have here 4176. Now what if you want to check whether I have done this is correct or not? So you can take 2 2's are 4 and 10 5's are 50. Here 2 2's are 4 and 2 5's are 10 plus balance the values is equal to 20. Now we have 4176. Here we can't directly put 102. What we have to do is, you have the number 52, right? So take 52, multiply it by 2. 2 2's are 4, 5 2's are 10. 104. So here your next number would be 104. Now here we have 4176. Now you have to find a number whose units place can be 6. Which number unit place can be 6? 4 square is equal to 16. 6 square is equal to 36. So 4 and 6. So 104. Either 4 will come or 6 will come. First let us try with 4. 1044 into 4. 4 4 is 16. Balance 1. 4 4 16 plus 1 17. Balance 1. 4 0 is 0 plus 1 is 1. 4 1 is 4. 4 1 7 6. 4 1 7 6. So directly now you can subtract them. Minus 4 1 7 6. Now 1044 into 4. You have to remember, whatever number you are putting here, be sure to put it on the quotient also. So then you get the answer 0, 0, 0, 0. That's it. So your answer is equal to 524. This is only the method of division. I know it is a little bit complicated, but if you try to understand it once, it will be very easy. Now, I can tell you some ways by which you can also practice with these big numbers of sum. For example, if you take any random number, like if you take any random 5-digit number or 6-digit number and try to find its square root, it won't be so easy to find the square root of that. I'll tell you a way. Take any 3-digit number. For example, you want to find the square, take any 3-digit number like 640. Take your calculator, multiply 640 by 640. You will get one answer. Take that answer and then try to find out the square root. Now, let me explain you. If I take my calculator and write 524 into 524, I will get my answer as 274576. 524 into 524 is equal to 274576. Now take this number and try to find out the square root of this number. And if your answer comes 524, then it is correct. So this is how you can find out many different values. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. We have completed squares and square roots. In the next video, we will start cube or cube roots in max. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. If you have enjoyed this video, press the like button. If you are new to the channel, subscribe to this channel. Press the bell icon for more updated notifications. And share this video to your friends if you find this informative. See you next time in the next video. Thank you and goodbye.